Hi, I'm Graham Steele, CEO and founder of Cryptosense, and today I'm going to tell you about code signing and the SolarWinds Orion breach. So, unless you've been on the moon for the last 2 weeks, you would have heard about this security incident that everyone's talking about around SolarWinds. So, SolarWinds is an IT company based in Texas that sells a IT monitoring product called Orion, amongst other things. This product is used by very sensitive companies, so more than 400 of the Fortune 500 largest companies and a lot of government agencies to monitor all of their IT. And it seems that sometime in March 2020, just when everybody was going into lockdown, trying to figure out how to do remote work and really not watching things, a build server somewhere inside SolarWinds was compromised so that some malicious code was put into a software update that went out to all of the Orion customers and then inserted a backdoor into their IT monitors that allowed a malicious hacking group to get into all of these customers' systems and get hold of all kinds of interesting sensitive data and do a whole bunch of nasty things that we're only going to find out about probably over the next months and even years. So how did this happen? Well, a lot of the forensic details are only just coming to light, but what we do know is that it shouldn't be possible for a malicious third party to just inject a Trojan or inject bad code into a software update. And one of the mechanisms that tries to stop this from happening is signature code signing. So every time you pull in an update to code on your Windows machine or wherever it is, the operating system checks that this update has a valid signature. So it checks that the software update that's about to be applied, that once we've done a hash over that whole software update and we sign that hash, that hash verifies when I check it out on my machine. On my machine, I've got the public keys of the operating system, so in this case it would be Microsoft, and they have given a certificate to the signing certificate of the company that's producing the software. So there's a whole verifiable certificate chain that your software can run down to check that the update it's receiving really is coming from the party it should be coming from and that it's actually been signed by that party by their private key. So that should mean that a third party can't just inject bad code in there. But obviously in this case, they did manage to do that. So the question is, how did they get around it? Well, there's two basic possibilities here. So generally speaking, inside a company, the idea isn't that you just do all your software work and then when you're just about to ready to sign the package, put it out the door, you just grab that package, sign it and send it off. You're supposed to track all of the updates and all of the changes that are made to that software cryptographically yourself before you do the final signature. So the idea is that you have inside your own company a sort of mini supply chain of your developers. The developers have all got keys they can use to sign their check-ins. You verify these. Also, if you're putting in third-party libraries, you might have a sort of bill of materials for these third-party stuff, and you're checking all of those hashes and checking those signatures, and your signature server will only issue a signature on your new update if it's checked all of the signatures on all of the materials that are coming in to be part of that new update that you're going to send out. So that should prevent a malicious third party that's got access somewhere in your network from being able to insert their own code inside. But obviously something didn't work here. So it's possible that the third party managed to inject something legitimately into a developer update. It's possible that this mechanism doesn't work correctly inside SolarWinds so that the verification of those updates isn't happening properly before a signature is issued. But it's also possible that their cryptographic keys were compromised. So generally a key that's so important, something like the key you used to sign your updates that you've had the public key part of certified by Microsoft, for example, for your Windows updates, you keep that private half of the key somewhere very secure, for example, inside a hardware security module in your infrastructure, and you have a very controlled way of accessing that. So only a very specific host on your network with a very tight gateway can actually get through and use that private key. But every now and then, private keys like that do get breached. So for example, way back in 2011, there was a very famous breach of the private key from inside a CA, a certification authority in the Netherlands called DigiNotar, which was used by another APT type actor, so a very sophisticated state level threat actor. And the DigiNotar team realized that there were certificates out in the wild that they didn't have any record of having signed through their infrastructure, and somehow that private key was being used in an unauthorized way. And it's possible that kind of thing has happened here too, so that it is possible. So what can we say about that part? So there's a lot of pieces to this puzzle of this malware. It's incredibly sophisticated. I think it's actually legitimate to call this one sophisticated, and there'll be lots of pieces of that. But in terms of checking your code signing system, you might want to think about keeping a tight inventory on the cryptographic assets that make that work. So starting with the private key that actually signs your updates, and then the way in between that you measure access to that, you store those keys, the intermediate keys that get checked in the chain to make sure that the thing you're about to sign really is legitimate. So you might want to look at your cryptography inventory and how you keep that up to date to make sure you know where things are, how they're protected, who has access to them, and so on. If you're interested in HSMs and how they get breached, we have a few more videos on the channel that might be interesting for you about that. If not, if you've got any more questions about code signing, please go ahead, put them in the comments, and I'll try and answer them in a future video. And to stay up to date with more crypto news from here at CryptoSense, go ahead and hit subscribe. Otherwise, take care, and I'll see you soon again here on the channel.